Lovator. Living it up while I'm going down. Oh my God, it's so good to hear that. It's so good to say this, Geoff, and I'm going to say it right now.
Say it out loud, say it proud.
108.9 The Hawk, the Valley's greatest classic rock station. I am Jason Gore in the 108.9 The Hawk morning show with my good friend,
Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. And Jason, it is good to have you back, wow. I got to say.
Wow. Now, so I am in the morning show. Wisp is not here today. He has taken some, if you could see me, I'm doing quotation marks.
These
are huge.
Marks.
It's full hands. It's full. Even doing fingers. It's the whole hand.
I was like, is he double hand waving at me?
Yeah,
nope.
What is this?
Those are quotes.
So he's taking some time to rest. He's kind of gotten into it with Boss Ron.
I've been here. You've been on a lot of remotes. I apologize for that.
I've been doing so many remotes.
It's been appreciated. But
I was locked in Wisp's car. He considered that a remote.
And I kept telling him, put the window down. And that was unfair.
Well,
that was unfair, Wisp. I will
you.
Say that. I'm in your court.
Okay.
But I will say, yes, he has had a lot of anger issues, I would say. And I'm Geoff the Anger Man Garlock saying anger issues here.
Hey, you are saying anger.
I am saying anger. Give me fuel, give me fire, give me him being angry at Boss Ron because of he is not
you
very
desire.
Into,
you desire. You have
I,
to end
I desire,
it with I desire,
et cetera, et cetera. But because
so try it again. Try it again.
Give me fuel. Give me fire. Give me that which Boss Ron desires is more
you said,
great.
No. You said right, what? No, okay. That's not a word. Go ahead. Start it again.
I was happy to have you back, Jason.
No, I'm happy
I'm
to
just,
be here. I just want this to be perfect. I want the show
to
be
to
perfect.
Have you back.
Oh, no,
I've got
great.
Double
oh,
hand
I
wave.
See this now.
Can
fine.
We not
okay.
start this way?
Can we play the? Oh, we'll play this game. We'll play this game.
Let's not play this
damn
game.
Show.
All
this
damn
will be great. This will be such
fuel,
a good show.
Give me fire. Give me that which Boss Ron desires.
Very good.
More that Greg good. Lemon Sour. He wants more Greg Lemon Sour. And
hey, I gotta say, man, I'm sorry. I might be Team Greg. Have you listened to Going Deep with Greg Lemon Sour? Those are the, I mean, he's got the dusty grooves.
Yes.
Geoff.
I have listened to it when I did my show.
Going deeper
with Geoff the Anger Man Garlock. Do you not remember I had my own show of dusty grooves?
Was that
grooves?
On this station?
Yes, it was on this station. I mean, it was on Wednesdays in the morning at the 3:45 a.m., but it was a show until he gave it to Robbie Agatocles and made it into Dark Side of the Swamp. But, none of these people are here. We are here together.
You okay?
Me.
Do you need some water? Are you okay? You see, I'm doing hand quotes here.
So you
are
don't
you okay?
care. You
are
don't
you
care
okay,
if
Geoff?
I'm okay. We are,
no, I do care.
We are doing
do
wonderful.
All I'm saying is you could have maybe stood up a little bit more for me when I was in the depths of radio hell. Hey, but it's good to be here. It's the 108.9 The Hawk Morning Show. You may have heard me just say this. 108.9 The Hawk, the Valley's greatest classic rock station. That is how we are saying we are now. Sure, we are number 9 in Valverde, out of a list of two classic rock stations.
The thing is, you can't take away what we are saying legally.
Right. You can't take that away.
Who can judge? It is up to someone to decide if a station is the greatest. Much like if someone advertises this is the world's greatest cup of coffee, who's to say?
Who's to say?
Except for James Beard sometimes, but not James Beard ain't coming to here.
No, he's not. I wish there was. If there were a James Beard for classic rock radio. Oh, we'd have that beard. I'd have a beard. You'd have a beard.
If we could be gunning for like a Linet star, it would be the ghost of Phil Linet.
That's what it'd be, the Linet stars.
Yes, and he'd be telling you how many solo and Soho LPs you get for how good
one
your station is.
One through five
solo
nice
and Sohos. And you know what?
Right.
I'm going to say we're five solo and Sohos with one Huey Lewis playing harmonica.
Oh, my God.
Alive and dangerous.
Oh, my God. That is how you do it. Hey, it is the 108.9 The Hawk Morning Show. Good morning, 7:05. A lot to get through this morning. Big news. Huge, huge news. Geoff, I know you're excited about this. Aerosmith's back for a residency at Valmart Amphitheater. We're going to be giving away tickets. They're doing 40 shows in a row at Valmart Amphitheater. It's going to be so cold for those shows because, as you know, Valverde is cold, man. It's so cold here, and it's all outdoors there.
As you know, at the amphitheater, even colder. They do not turn down the air conditioning.
They do not. They do not. They have gigantic fans that are you can purchase at Valmart.
Which is the problem. Why are they selling fans that also blow around the air conditioner? There are a lot of problems here, not to mention all those raccoons outside that keep attacking people.
Oh, my God.
Ah, the raccoons outside of there. But
at both the dome and the amphitheater, we have a real...
The raccoons have been migrating because now, of course, we're entering into fall. And that is when raccoons migrate from arena to arena.
You don't have to tell me. I've got my pumpkin spice soda dad right here, and I'm just...
Oh, God. If you thought that soda dad was going to destroy your stomach, it is going to destroy it times a thousand with pumpkin spice soda dad. And again, people,
destroy
that
it
is
times
the
a
copy.
Thousand.
That is what has been said.
Okay. That's a good That's good copy.
That's
that
the
is
copy.
Good
what
copy.
Can we say? They've been giving us this copy, and that is what's going on here. You know, we just follow the copy.
Also coming up, Farmer Dan from Shetland Creameries is coming by. He wants to talk about fall festival days going on at Shetland Creameries. And then, oh, God, because, of course, fall festival days happening at Shetland Creameries until November 28th. We also have to talk about Mickey Mac is broadcasting live from the Motor Mile today from 3 until 6. We may hear from him. He may call in. Free cars.
I tell you, everybody's happy. Everybody's happy
Mickey Mac comes in, everybody's happy. But he's going to be out at the Motor Mile from 3 until 6. Here's the promotion, Geoff. I don't know if this is something. This is probably something that interests you, being without a car and everything.
Free Arlo car. Guthrie, I'm still gunning for you, you son of a bitch.
Free car if you can outrun them.
Outrun the car?
Yes.
So
basically, it's a man versus machine situation. They put you next to a brand new vehicle out at the Motor Mile. If you can outrun it, and they're not saying what the speed's going to be.
No, I mean, I'm assuming fast.
Oh, I'm assuming fast, too. And the signs do say assume fast.
So this is sort of like a Running Man situation.
This is very much a Running Man.
This is like when you're fighting against Dynamo, and Dynamo's coming. He's singing some opera, and he's like, oh, and you're getting gunned down.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh.
So you,
wow,
if you can outrun it.
I could. And that's the thing. Every time I watch The Running Man, and you've heard me say this.
Oh, God,
I say, Geoff
every
the
day.
Anger Man Garlock says this all the time. Every time I watch The Running Man, I say, I could do that.
Oh, yeah.
I could do that. Buzzsaw.
And that's why I stopped watching The Running Man with you.
We had our weekly friendship appointment. Meet up at someone's apartment, usually not mine because I haven't had one in a while.
You haven't had one. Usually you come over to my house.
I come over to your house and it makes me sad how big of a backyard you have. And
it's
we
huge.
Get a nice big spread of flapper's wings.
Mm.
We get all the flavors you can imagine.
All the flavors.
Oh, kerosene and sriracha is one of my faves lately. And
that
then we
good.
Just put in that VHS of The Running Man. And just let it roll. And it has tracking issues. And that doesn't matter.
It's all over the place.
It is jumping.
It is all over the place.
I'm not even convinced we've been watching the movie half the time.
It may not. It could be Sliver with Sharon Stone, for all I know.
I will say, I saw Billy Balls in there. And I'm wondering if I taped over one part. Maybe the part where Buzzsaw gets that.
Was Billy Balls in The Running Man?
No,
that's the
thing. I think
that's
taped
confusing.
Over with a bit of Sliver.
Yeah.
My favorite moments of Sliver.
Of course, Billy Baldwin. We refer to him as Billy Balls because he's a friend of the show.
Oh, he's a friend of the show.
Billy Balls, if you're listening, hey, it's good to be back in the morning show. Hi.
good to see you.
Oh, my God. So Aerosmith, fall festival days. And then today, ladies and gentlemen, right in the studio with us right now, we can go ahead and say hello. 706 on 108.9 The Hawk, Sage Lukather. Am I saying that right? Is it Lukather?
It's Sage Lukather.
Lukather.
Lukather. Yes.
Like what? Like Steve Lukather?
You got it.
Wait.
I'll clear it up for you guys.
Please. All right. Clear it up.
Yes. My father is a legendary guitarist, session musician, and you might know him from the band Toto, Steve Lukather.
I might know him from the band Toto.
I definitely know him from the band.
it's always a pleasure to meet fans. And
I got to say, that's why I was wondering why you were wearing a kimono. And yeah. It's because you're a Lukather.
That's just part of also just sort of my style. If I could just ask you guys real quick before we get going here. My Chevy Bolt is in the parking lot. And I saw some raccoons, and they're sort of gnawing at the tires, and it's an electrical vehicle. So if there's somebody that could run out and take a look, make sure that everything's
Scotty,
okay.
Scotty, could you run out?
Jenny? Where's Jenny and Jimmy?
Oh, my God. Where are
tight
they?
Tight squeeze here in this studio, though, but I appreciate it.
Oh, no. It's roomy for a classic rock studio.
And I just want to ask, is this being simulcast on the internet, will be released as a podcast? This is sort of the FM radio, sort of a I don't want to say a dying medium, but
we would never say
you to say that either.
I work in technology, of course.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
we keep up with the kids. We're simulcast broadcasts on the elderly channel, so don't you worry.
We are
about
on the elderly channel. Hi, wave to the cameras. Hi, everyone on the elderly
channel.
Take
a break from your sit and stand exercise classes and take a listen to our friend here. Yeah, so don't worry. We're top of line. So you're in technology here. Interesting.
Yes. This is a podcast too. Boss Ron did start that. I haven't heard it.
I'm not even positive what a podcast is. I should. I don't know.
Not really sure what it is.
I think
I can explain it to you. It starts with an RSS feed, and then that.
What does RSS stand for?
Okay, you've lost me. Well, RSS stands for.
You know what? I'm gonna
rock, sounding sexy, right?
That's probably what it is, right?
I'm gonna
try because what I'm here today to talk to you about. I'm gonna try to keep it as least technical as possible.
Talk to us like we are just random old fashioned idiots.
I don't think that'll be a problem.
Just morons who haven't left terrestrial radio.
Oh, we're already having fun.
No.
Oh, Scotty just came back. I think he looked at your car.
Yeah.
He's shaking his head. No, I don't know what that means.
Are the raccoons not chewing on his cord, or
if we could just
he's holding a cable.
Okay, not good. That's not good. I might. That's all right.
That's the migration of the raccoons for you.
I'll call a ride sharing service after the show, and we'll figure it out. Thank you guys so much for having me.
Thank you so much for being here. Now, we buried the lead here. You are working on a brand new VR experience. Of Woodstock 99.
Are we in the Lawnmower Man? What is this?
Oh, my God. Oh.
Yes,
Geoff Fahey, let me out.
The Lawnmower Man is just the tip of the iceberg of what we are doing over at Lukather.
Really?
I am Sage Lukather.
It doesn't get better than Lawnmower Man.
I mean, I thought that was the whole iceberg,
that's the whole iceberg. What sunk the Titanic.
What if I could take you back to a decommissioned Air Force base?
Oh, my God.
In 1999.
Okay. Oh, my God.
And you could experience the joy of the Woodstock 99 festival. What if I could put you there and you could do it from the comfort of your living room?
Oh,
are you kidding me?
I've dreamt of this.
Literally, last night I dreamt of this. I dreamt of having a VR experience of going to be able to experience Woodstock 99 again. You're telling me this can happen?
That dream is now a reality, yes.
So I put on one of those goggle things, right?
And this is the great thing about it is it's not quite open source. We would never do that. It's you can use an Oculus. You can use any sort of VR headset. And then you can.
I can use my brand new Valve Eyes.
Yes, absolutely. Whatever VR headset you want. And then if you have, a bodysuit the hand stuff, you can.
I did just buy the Valmart hand stuff.
You can experience the walk in real time from the east to the west stage, feeling it in real time, the 2.3 miles
oppressive
heat, and be at Woodstock 99
from the
very beginning, even the early pre-day of Woodstock 99, and you can be up there interacting with the crowd or seeing G-Love and Special Sauce.
Oh, that was going to be my first question. Yeah. Am I going to be able to see G-Love?
That was my first question. I jotted this down right. On my pad, it says, can I see G-Love and Special Sauce?
Yes, you can see them. Not only
unbelievable.
Because what we've done is we have taken all of the technology, all of the video from the Woodstock 99 festival.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
uh-huh.
It was covered extensively by MTV.
Oh,
not
everybody
to
did,
mention
yeah.
all of the people who brought their individual camcorders.
Oh,
we've
wow.
up-res that. Not to get too technical, we've up-res that to 8K.
Okay, starting to lose me, but all right, I'm going.
360 virtual reality experience, so you can be at Woodstock 99. And what's most exciting about this, you guys, what's most exciting is you can choose, you can be a festival attendee.
Okay, okay.
You can be Fred Durst yourself.
Oh, that was my, wow. I had this right here on my pad. It says,
it is
G-Love, and then can I be Fred Durst?
Yes, you can. It is a absolute immersive experience, and it's a community, too. It's a community.
What about Flea?
Flea, absolutely. It is an amazing thing. I've actually
what about,
brought a
what,
couple
what,
of the,
what about bassist Tim Comerford?
Yes, oh. Tim Comerford, absolutely. Anybody you want to be. If you want to be Sheryl Crow, that's entirely up to you. If
really?
You want to
Do
be
I want
Bad
to
Boy
be?
Slim in the rave tent on you know, Friday into Saturday night, you can be DJing as Fat Boy Slim. You could also be experiencing the feeling of taking too much ecstasy and not drinking enough water and being trapped in the, it's all there. The complete Woodstock 99 experience. It is virtual reality is not enough to explain where we're at.
This is next level.
It is next level.
Hey, I'd say this is next level, guys.
I think this is next level.
I am, I'm just
unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Would I
be here?
I guess if I'm thinking a next level, would I be able to put myself in the eyes of, if I could guess anyone, any person that was at Woodstock 99, could I be John Scheer? The one of the promoters, like not
that
Michael Lang. I never want to be Michael Lang. I'd like to be the guy. I want to make excuses.
Thing.
That's what, because I like to be angry. I'm Geoff the Angry Man Garlock, and I like to get angry
Absolutely.
About other people.
You can experience Woodstock 99 as if you are the promoter. There is a Michael Lang avatar.
Wow.
So you can be
really?
Michael Lang if you want.
Wow.
It's however you want to experience the festival. There are no rules in our virtual Woodstock.
Okay,
now.
This is a dream
okay.
for all boomers out there. I got to tell you.
This
to
is
be
a dream for me. I've been worried about this whole virtual reality thing because I'm a classic rock guy. I come in here and, this is the technology I need. All of this really old ass radio equipment.
You're also a famed Luddite. You really don't trust technology.
I don't trust technology.
I
don't.
And I understand that. And what I'll say to you is this is technology that you're going to get comfortable with. It's very, very easy to use. You just slip the helmet on.
Uh-huh.
And
yep.
then you are instantly, it's just like you're in your apartment. It's as easy as working a microwave, except instead of doing
I don't do that very well.
No, he does not.
Instead of putting in a Stouffer's, meal, you just flip a switch and then, hey, I am in Buck Cherry. Or I am
climbing
a
So I'm saying crazy
tower.
Bitch?
Yeah, you can say
So
crazy
I'm
bitch.
Literally saying, hey, you're a crazy bitch, but you fuck so good, I'm on top of it.
Yeah, like I said, we've got all of the music licensing.
Is it in my voice?
Yeah, what happens is you speak into your microphone,
okay.
but it will come
like
out.
Like this microphone.
Yes, it's the microphone attached to the headset. You can use that as an optional plug-in mic. It's whatever you want to bring to it.
Oh, my God.
It doesn't matter what equipment you have. But if you buy, into this, and you can also virtually purchase in-game or in Woodstock 99 experience.
In Rome.
When in Rome.
When in
you
Rome.
Can do
when
whatever.
In Rome.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
is that a reference now to Sublime with Rome, of course.
Yes,
yes
Sublime
of course.
With Rome. Although, they, of course, weren't at Woodstock 99.
Oh,
it
of
is
course
an authentic experience. So you can get a virtual bottle of water for $7.
Oh my God.
That's a dream.
Okay, Sage, I'm just going to throw some names out there. You say yes or no if I can be these people.
Okay.
Linda Rutherford and Celtic Fire.
You can be Linda Rutherford. You can be one of the Celtic Fire.
Just, please let it be the flute player.
Yes, absolutely.
All right, let me throw this.
There are no limits.
Okay.
Can I be, let's just say, guy who wears the diaper in P-Funk All-Stars?
Absolutely.
Oh, can you smell the diaper?
Yeah, see, now this is, I want to be honest with you.
Is there any diaper leaks?
It's an immersive experience.
Uh-huh.
However,
wow.
And there are limitations to the technology. As we roll out our 2.0 of Woodstock 99, we are going to be incorporating some of the smells. So, the Parliament Funkadelic diaper, also the porta potties, that is coming.
That's what I was
going
to ask. That's on my little list here to ask.
You wanted to be a porta potty.
I wanted to be the pita potty is what we call it here in Valverde, but I would like to be the porta potty.
Yes. Not the pita potty where you can get a gyro while you go to the porta potty.
Yes. And only in Valverde.
You can be sitting in the comfort of your Valverde home, which I'm sure is
very comfortable. Mine is very warm and inviting.
All right, you don't got to put salt in my wounds, all right?
Okay. You can be in go from comfort to extreme discomfort simply by slipping on the virtual reality.
So my house to Geoff's. Is basically what you're saying in terms of levels.
I'm not going to get
in the middle. Don't put words in his mouth here. Okay?
We're having fun. And speaking of immersive experiences, ladies and gentlemen, we do have to go to traffic. It's Art Spart.
108.9 The Hawk traffic with Art Spart.
Wow! I like mine with lettuce and tomato. Heinz 57 and French fried potatoes. Big kosher pickle and a cold draft beer and not spread all over the interstate, which is what we've got going on in Valverde today. That is right. It is a traffic seminar out there with the main lesson, don't jackknife a truck delivering burgers, which the driver of the Jimmy Buffett Burger Delivery Service had gotten that lesson and not skipped a day because it is a mess out there. As you all know, Jimmy Buffett is now the main supplier for cheeseburgers for our beloved burger tools. And another tasty delivery of cheeseburgers were coming our way until they hit that patch of black ice on Phil Lynott Avenue, flipped over the Boscaggs Interstate, colloquially known as the Scattered State, and landed right in the middle of Ugly Kid Joe Way. Which is slowly becoming the most dangerous part of Valverde. It is a catastrophe. Limbs everywhere. Blood flowing like water in the streets. Big kosher pickles as far as the eye can see. And worst of all, no burgers are going to be arriving at Burger Tools anytime soon. Jimmy Buffett and Richard Karn. This was a merger that was created in the heavens and now has brought us into hell. And that's traffic on the Hawk. I'm Art Spart.
It's time for weather on 108.9 The Hawk.
I haven't done this in a while.
You do the honors.
God, this is good. Cold.
Freezing cold.
It is freezing cold. Always freezing cold.
Those burgers have got to be freezing out there.
Very cold here.
It's very cold. Always cold.
That's why it's always been like this. That's why it's good to have this Woodstock 99 VR experience. Because,
man, you're reading my mind. You can be transferred to the 103 degree heat of the asphalt of a decommissioned naval base.
Wow.
And you can, if this is up to you, you can be Robbie Krieger as he joins Creed on stage.
No.
Said my Make-A-Wish wish. If John Cena ever showed up to do a Make-A-Wish for Geoff the Angry Man Garlock, it would be make me look like shriveled Robbie Krieger just climbing up there to play some guitar acts.
I just want to be Robbie Krieger. Up there in like some dumb like American flag pants or something like that.
Just something that doesn't fit them right.
And that's the great thing. You can change your outfit. Change your avatar. It can be Robbie Krieger in American flag pants.
Yes.
You can then put him in an ascot. If you, and of course, any of the, all the instruments, they're period correct. They're pretty correct.
So God.
I don't know what the organ is. All of our R&D people did this right, but I believe it's the white keys are black and the black keys are white. When you look down at the keyboard to play, to, you know, you're going to be able
So you can be Manzarek
playing a harpsichord while he's wearing an ill-fitting American flag pantsuit.
All I have ever wanted in this world.
And probably Arne sunglasses.
And the great thing is, at the click of a button, you can go from being in Collective Soul to just being a concert goer. And when I say that there are no limits in the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience, there are no limits. You can do whatever you want.
Wow.
Well, we're going to get
I imagine if you are one of the concert goers, you're probably always going to be shirtless and with a tribal tattoo. But, you know, that's just a given, right?
Go over to the tribal tattoo tent.
Right.
And, you know, you just hook your credit card up and then your avatar will have the tribal tattoo of your choice.
No better place to get a tribal tattoo than Woodstock 99. I tell you, I bet you it was healthy and totally not giving you an infection.
And that's why we created the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience, is because there's so many people that didn't get to attend Woodstock 99, that missed out on the fun, that missed out on the excitement, that missed out on the energy, the vibe. And a lot of people have asked, why have you not used this technology to recreate the original Woodstock Festival from 1969?
I do have a question. Why have you not taken this technology to recreate the original Woodstock?
Neil Young.
Yeah, you did have the question that he already presented. That is great.
Neil Young.
By the way, I just need to apologize to you. Jason's been in a closet and in a car, and he's been on some remotes for a while.
I have been at a stakes competition.
He was at the Wild Things water park, and that did not go well.
This is my first time back in studio.
He hasn't done any interviews in a while, so we apologize.
Mr.
Lukather.
Mr. Lukather is my
father's name. Hey, can we call you Mr. Lukather?
father's name.
Oh, you guys got art.
Got that one.
Oh, my God. Well, we're going to get into this some more. You know what?
He played on Thriller.
That is true.
Michael Jackson.
Oh, your daddy.
Yeah.
Your little daddy.
Your little daddy played on Thriller.
My daddy played on a lot of records.
Your daddy play on a lot of records.
I really honestly wish I could say, like, if somebody's like, what did your dad do? I would no longer say auditor. I would say my daddy played on Thriller.
I would no longer be ashamed to answer that question. Instead, I would be saying my daddy did the Dune soundtrack. And I'm talking about the good one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And we're going to be talking about a lot of good ones coming up. We're going to be giving away those Aerosmith tickets. We are going to hear from Farmer Dan and more about this VR experience right now. Oh, I am psyched for that residency. Valmart Amphitheater. Aerosmith, right here. 108.9 The Hog.
Hey! One breast, one thigh. One chicken, one wing, one drumstick. One chicken, one broiled, one fried, one sauteed, one chicken.
Hello, this is Eddie Mercury. No, I'm not Freddie Mercury, but I am the owner of One Chicken, the premier Queen-based chicken shop. It's a chicken that's just as unique as the band Queen. You see, every week here at One Chicken, we only serve
one chicken.
We get one chicken imported every single week, and we chop it up into various pieces. We throw out at least one wing and one drumstick. And then, much like a Queen record, we are not held back by genre. We'll cook it however we feel like. Just like a Queen record might go into a barbershop quartet song, our chicken might be flame broiled. Just like a Queen record might turn into a bombastic, prog, epic, operatic song, we might do something crazy with our chicken that week. Maybe baste it in a small brew root beer for 24 hours before we cover it all in frosted flakes. Whatever we want to do to chicken, we do it here at Queen's One Chicken, located in Val Verde.
One breast, one broasted, one barbecued, one chicken. One chicken. It's unique and specific all at the same time, just like Queen was.
Hi, I'm Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs with Val Verde Memorial Hospital. A lot of you wrote to us after our last spot in pure disbelief about how I'm still employed as Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs. Well, it's an easy answer. I'm Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs. If you think Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs is going to fire Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs, well, you'd be correct. Because due to recent events at Val Verde Memorial Hospital, Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs has effectively terminated the employment of Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs. However, seeing as how Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs is the only Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs in Val Verde that can fill the role of Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs, I, Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs, have effectively rehired myself as Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs. I may not be an award-winning Chief Medical Person, but I'm the only Chief Medical Person in Val Verde. Rest assured that Val Verde can continue to rely on Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs at Val Verde Memorial Hospital. Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs. Shut up, I'm the only Chief Medical Person.
It's real. Brunch is now available at all Sharnies.
All you create, all you destroy, all that you do. All you say, all that you eat, at Sharnies you're complete. Food that you love, no food that you hate. Food that is meat, food that is cheese, food that is lunch, and everything that comes with brunch never ends. Eat the brunch at Sharnies with friends.
There is no such thing as free food. Nobody eats for free.
God, I hope I hear this one. I hope I hear this one when I'm at 40 shows. I'm going all 40, Geoff.
You got to go to all 40 if they're coming.
You got to go to all 40. I'm going to be there all 40 shows, and you can be too. Caller number 108 right now. Here is the sounder.
Hey, it's me, Joe Perry from Aerosmith. And right now, be caller 108 on 108.9 The Hawk. And you'll get tickets to see any one of our 40 shows coming up at Valmart Amphitheater as part of our Aerosmith residency right here in Val Verde. We're really excited to be here and, wrap it up? Okay. Caller number 108 right now.
That's it. Caller number 108 right now. The phones are lighting up for
this.
I gotta
tell you, he's sounding good, too.
That really Joe Perry? Was that, or did you use, because we use a lot of AI technology to recreate the voices?
That was actually Joe Perry.
Yeah, because it's getting good. I can't tell the difference.
No, like, literally, I've heard AI Joe Perry, and actually sounds more like a human than actual Joe Perry at this point.
It does. Yeah, I bet it does.
Problem is you can't hear the mustache in the AI. That's the problem.
No. You can't hear it.
You can hear it when he's really talking.
He faces the mic. So if he's the face in the mic and his nose is going up and down like this, you're not going to hear it because there's no mustache there.
Yeah, and Depp said you got to eat that mic.
He said you got to listen to Depp.
We've said this
you
a billion times.
You got to listen to Depp.
You got to listen to Depp.
The greatest slide guitarist
greatest
known to man.
Slide guitarist.
I haven't
ever.
Been in the morning show in a while, but I still know that fact.
Yeah, that's just a fact.
I am just so proud of our development team on this Woodstock 99 project.
Oh, I bet.
Because they have absolutely just nailed the voices of each member of Los Lobos.
Really?
Yeah, it is just incredible.
And those are hard, too, because we all know the voices of all the individual members of Los Lobos. And we're like, you better get this goddamn voice right.
Exactly.
Hey, guys, I got to do this really fast. Caller number 23.
Did I get them tickets?
No, you're caller number 23. We're looking for 108.
Oh, shit.
Okay, keep on getting them through here.
Hey, and by the way, if you're calling in, don't swear.
Scotty did...
We get into enough trouble, I gotta say, lately with swearing. Here's the thing.
We get into so much trouble for swearing.
Now,
people don't understand. I think the podcast is going out, and I don't know if this is sure because, like we said earlier, we don't know much about podcasts.
That's why we got Lukather over here.
But Boss Ron is putting these out as podcasts. I think he is taking the pre-delay feed and putting that out. Because if you're listening
on... That would make sense. That would make sense.
If you're listening on 108.9, the frequency in Val Verde, you never hear us curse.
Never.
You never ever hear it. Why would
can
you?
Can I ask you a technical question about radio?
Oh, please.
Radio?
Yeah, no, please
I'm sure we won't be able to answer it, but give us a whirl.
No, yeah. Because sometimes
I'm just
going
to say fire.
Sometimes I'll be listening to a radio station, an FM radio station.
Okay.
And occasionally I will hear it cut out like because somebody is cursed. And I hear like little digital artifacting for about 1 to 2 minutes. Is that because somebody is hitting the 7 second delay?
I think it's sort of like a
little digital artifact.
I'll tell you. I got a theory.
You got a theory. You take it. Here's my theory.
Here's the problem.
Hold on. Caller 73. Oh, yeah. You are not the caller.
Well, fuck. Okay, I'll call back.
Okay, again, people stop swearing but I think they're getting used to, here's what you're hearing. Especially with Wisp, he was getting us so riled up, and then our swearing was just getting out of control.
Out of control.
We've gotten up to like a 53-second delay sometimes. Mm-hmm. So what I think you're hearing is the digital scrubbing going through.
Yeah.
And we just keep talking sometimes. We just talk through the delay.
We just keep going. I think it's before it hits the delay is what you're hearing on the podcast.
Does it sound like a fax noise, like a screeching, low level.
What I would describe, it's something that we have worked really hard in our VR experience to smooth out. But what it sounds like is it almost sounds like somebody's talking very fast, a little bit robotic, and it's like a little bit sped up. Like I'm trying to do an impression of it.
Well, sometimes we do that.
Yes, sometimes we just do.
Sometimes we get
a lot of callers who, again, they're talking about these podcasts and we don't know about them, but they just keep saying, can you guys just 1.5 or 2 times it?
Yeah.
And so we try and we say, that seems like an insane way to listen to anything.
So
you're rewiring your brain when you're doing it, but if we want to stay one of the greatest classic rock stations.
The greatest.
The greatest. Thank you.
Hey, speaking of, case in point, I'm going to give you an example of the speed up. Right now, I got to go to the phones. It's caller 101. Caller 101, you are on the air.
Yeah, did I get them tickets?
Yep.
Fuck.
Okay, stop swinging.
Okay, well, see, and that's not even...
Yeah,
then,
see, that was...
Care. That's exactly how
and
it goes.
That's 1.5 right there.
Oh, Geoff, do you want to take this? 108, here we go.
Hey, this is Greg Lemon Sour calling in. Hey, I've been getting those tickets.
Greg, hi. Yeah. You can't. You work for the station.
Oh, excuse me?
You don't. You work for the station.
No. This is Greg Lemon Sour in a lot of ways.
No, I know who it is. Hi, it's Jason Gore. How are you?
The station works for me, all right? Greg Lemon Sour from Going Deep. I'm pulling some of the dustiest grooves, all right? Are we good here? Yeah. Are we all right?
We're great. I enjoy... All right? Greg, I really enjoy the show.
We haven't really met formally yet.
We have never met. We have never met because I'm usually doing remotes while you're doing whatever. You're maybe in the studio. You're off,
what am I doing? I'm
show.
Pulling the deepest Captain Beefheart cuts that you've ever heard, bootlegs that
I've
you've
heard
never
them,
even
it's great.
Seen.
It's
oh,
great.
Wait a second. You enjoy Beefheart?
I love Beefheart.
Wait a second.
See, if you took the time to get to know me and I wasn't like shat out into the fucking barren ass of Val Verde all the time to do remotes.
You know what, Jason?
You'd find
I'm going to take this up with station manager Ron, all right?
Please
I'm pulling
do.
A lot of weight around here, so Greg Lemon Sour's got your back from now on. So speaking of, can you have my back? Can I get those Aerosmith tickets?
You can't. And we're going to hang up
now. So I'm not going to be honking on Bobo then,
up,
I suppose. Scotty. All right, fine.
Hey, Scotty, hang up. I do have to say, since, this is a rule, we don't have to institute it very much, but since a station employee messed that up, we have to reset the phones. We're starting back at 1.
Call
it 108 right
now.
That seems only fair. I think that seems very, very fair.
And he gets it. He gets the future. He gets technology. So, I mean,
speaking
if he's
of
saying
the
it's
future,
fair, then it's got to be fair.
Speaking of the future and getting it, we do have another guest in studio right now joining me, Jason Gore, and Geoff the Angry Man Garlock, and of course, Sage Lukather. You are the Chief Thought Officer. What's the name of your company again?
Chief Thought Officer Lukather VR, and we are the only people who are responsible for bringing you the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience.
One of the best experiences you're going to ever have.
That's amazing. And also,
anything goes in VR. I cannot stress this enough. You can do whatever you want at the Woodstock 99 virtual reality festival.
You can do whatever you want. We're going to get into this deep. We do have to bring in our second guest with us here. It is the one and only Farmer Dan, Shetland Creameries.
In the studio. Can you believe this?
Oh my, it's me, it's Farmer Dan.
Of course, yes, we did just introduce you, Farmer.
Hello,
I'm from Shetland Creameries, and we're talking fall festival days are happening right now at Shetland Creameries.
All right, Farmer Dan, I don't want to cut you off here, but you got to kind of... Did you hear our segment about our 1.5 and 2? Your haunted voice is actually kind of a...
Yeah, it's kind of creeping me out, but keep
I mean, but
on.
I guess it is fall. It is spooky season.
I smell a dairy. There's an overwhelming smell of dairy in this.
It does smell like sour milk. Is that... That's
it's
you,
me.
Farmer.
It's me. I was walking through the dairy vats this morning.
The dairy vats.
Dan, do you mind me asking, how many years young are you?
How many years young?
That's a beautiful way to ask that.
I always look at it as I'm 96 years dead.
Oh my God.
I see.
a terrifying way to look at that.
Slowly dying for 90.
I think you've got a pep in your step still
years.
There, Farmer Dan.
So...
You do look a bit like Dan Aykroyd in that movie,
guys.
Nothing But Trouble. But
that's my favorite movie.
Well, it's my favorite movie.
If Farmer Dan is interested, I have one of the VR sets with me, and we could put Farmer Dan in Woodstock 99.
Okay.
Would you like to try that?
Yeah, put it on me.
That'd be fantastic. I mean, he was there, so he could. If you didn't know, Farmer Dan was giving out milk at Woodstock 99 when
Here's
it got really
milk.
Hot.
And it was really wanted. Okay. This is amazing. If you have time, Farmer Dan, I'm going to put the headset on you, but after this, I'd love to do a photo shoot with you 360. So let's put this on. Can take you anywhere. We can put you. How about this? Farmer Dan. I'm going to put Farmer Dan, I'm going to put you into the crowd with the Offspring.
Wait, what day is this?
This is Friday on the East Stage.
So
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
It's July 23rd, 1999.
Yes, it is, Farmer Dan. You got that exactly right.
He was there. He may be old, but he has
a
record in his brain. Yeah.
James Brown came up to the East Stage and said, "Where's my goddamn milk?" And I said,
"Here." You met James Brown? Okay.
That's
a 10 on James Brown, by the way. You might want to get Farmer Dan sampled for the James Brown voice.
Because this is an ever-evolving project, I would love to integrate Farmer Dan. But right now, I'm going to put you back since you were there.
DMX.
You put the headset on.
Walked up to me.
I am going to... What did he say?
He said, "Where's my goddamn milk?"
Okay.
And I said, Do you see that cow over there? And he said, "Yes, I see the cow." I said, "Do you see it making milk?" And he said, "Yes, because when you look at a cow and you look in their eyes, you know they're filling it up down there."
This is actually interesting because it's filling in blanks for me. Jason, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put Farmer Dan. I'm going to put him Yes, I'm going to put you right into the moment. Then I believe a group of young men and women did somehow get a crowd into the mosh pit in between the Sheryl Crow and DMX set.
Part of the Sheryl Crow mosh pit.
Yeah. So here we go. Put the goggles on.
Okay, I'll put them. Here we go.
And
don't have a heart attack when you go back in time.
And you are there. And you can see how real it is. You can see it, yeah.
Cheryl Crow!
Now, the beauty I'm realizing is he doesn't need the 2.0 update because he's able to smell the milk on himself.
It's already on him.
Over here, Cheryl! I got your milk! Cheryl!
What's... And then, if we push a button, Yeah, there he is. You are on top of the tower. As the Red Hot Chili Peppers
have wisely
decided to play Fire by Jimi Hendrix.
Does it seem like the crowd thinks it's a good idea that they decided to play Fire?
See, the crowd seems way too into it. I'm not. Let me down.
Okay, now take off. Let's just take off those. Let me down. Goggles. Take off your goggles, Farmer Dan.
You gotta
Farmer
guide
Dan.
Him through this experience,
Farmer Dan. Take off the goggles and look. You're back in the studio. You're back in the studio. He was
throwing
pale.
Up dairy everywhere. This is no good. No, if I couldn't smell it before, which I could, I very much can smell all that dairy.
It's a very intense experience. Are you okay, Farmer Dan?
Someone's got to get all those kids off the tower.
Yeah,
it's a little
real.
Too late for that one.
I kept looking down and I said, "You kids, get off the tower." Anthony Kiedis is not gonna stop because he hasn't had his milk yet.
Oh, so this poses an interesting question. Do you think you could work on maybe like a multiverse update, maybe your 3.0, where maybe a Farmer Dan could go back in and try to change the reality, maybe like a quantum leap situation
for Farmer Dan.
I'm
glad you brought that up.
While
you can't change the events of Woodstock 99 as they played out, you can play as a member of the Woodstock 99 Peace Patrol. So you can walk around, and if you want to sell your Peace Patrol shirt for $100 to somebody, you can do that. We cannot change the events of Woodstock 99 within the game. They are going to play out as they're going to play out.
Oh, wow. So it's kind of like a sadder quantum leap.
Yeah. Okay.
But here, just blue skying.
You can't change.
Just blue skying. It's a quantum leap that you can't change. But what if the owl is played by your father, Steve Lukather? Because maybe that's who would have been the person who could have changed.
To be
Woodstock
honest,
Nightmare.
Trying to keep my father out of
Daddy Lukather.
Daddy Lukather could be
Daddy
a great
Lukather.
Listen, I love my daddy. I really do. He's terrific. But this is a venture that I am doing on my own. I'm sort of cutting my teeth because I'm the only one in the Lukather family who actually doesn't play an instrument.
Oh, wow. That's got to be tough.
That's got to sting.
It is a little tough. I've heard the words, you know, son, why can't you just simply play an A minor scale?
Like Steve Lukather.
I can't do it.
Hey, is Lukather in the room?
I think he might be.
Steve?
Is there a guy walking around in a kimono yelling about A minor scales? Nope. Okay.
No,
I don't see it.
Oh, thanks for answering, Farmer Dan.
Farmer Dan.
I looked around and there's no one in a kimono.
But if you were to put those goggles back on, and it's entirely up to you.
Okay. Here's the thing, boys. Mm-hmm. I made a lot of mistakes at Woodstock 99.
Okay.
That I would like to rectify.
Okay.
If I may suggest, I think you should record this for a further update, by the way.
I didn't give the Red Hot Chili Peppers their milk. When they asked and they said, "We're going to do something bad now."
Wow.
And I said, "What are you going to do?" And John Frusciante said, "He picked me up. He's such a strong man. He doesn't look like he's that strong. He's so strong.
He's a little man.
He's so strong. He picks me up one arm." And he says,
"Jamming on the other arm still."
It's the dexterity with his fingers.
Yes.
Oh my God. He lifts me up and he says, "Since I don't have my milk, this place is going to burn."
Oh, so now you're blaming it on Frusciante. He's the one who made it.
I'm blaming it on me.
You know, here's the interesting...
Farmer Dan.
You
are not responsible for the events that happened at Woodstock 99.
And then I was... Wes Borland came by afterwards. He was like, God, there's only one thing that'll make these eyes wide again.
And that's all we've been looking for, by the way, is to make Westmoreland's eyes wide again.
That's a good old frothy cup of milk.
Right? I think what you will find, Farmer Dan,
I didn't have it because my cow was just tapped.
It'll be cathartic for you.
I brought one cow.
Woodstock 99 was inevitable. It was inevitable. And you can go back and, quite frankly, you can't make it better. But you can, as I said, anything goes. You can make it worse.
Bruce Hornsby shot at me.
Because he said, yes. Where's his milk, I bet.
He did. He said, you can listen to the mandolin rain, or you can listen to this hot steel.
It's
and
not.
And he just fired off some bullets
at me. You know what I'm realizing?
It's not widely reported in the documentaries, but it is true. I can back it up because in designing this, Bruce Hornsby did bring a gun to Woodstock 99.
That is true. That, yes.
And you can play as Hornsby. And what's cool is you can change guns.
That's kind of like a Grand Theft Auto or something,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. It's sort of, This has everything.
This has everything I want.
Anything goes, guys.
Okay, you know, Farmer Dan, I got to say, I'm hearing all this
I'm thinking, Farmer Dan.
I know you are. Now, I think you got to stop beating yourself up. It sounds like you got a lot of trauma here. Stop drinking that soda, Dad.
This is my Shetland Creameries brand soda, Dad.
I'm sorry I even introduced a quantum leap situation. I was about to say this could be a Terminator situation where you could go back and change the past.
But this is more of a Terminator series situation.
As the sequels come out, you realize that every movie before it was pointless because no matter what, when they said no fate, there actually is a fate. T2 was a lie.
So, Sage, just for the sake of the show and the sake of Farmer Dan's, there's no way you can tweak a little code right now and let him fix this.
He is an old man.
He aged 2 years.
I just aged. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Everybody brings their own personality to the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience.
Oh,
so you bring to it what you want, okay? So
I want everyone to not be so goddamn angry at me.
So that's the thing. So
it out on the Air Force base.
So during break stuff, you know, you as Fred Durst, you have to let, as Fred Durst, it plays out as Fred Durst.
You're saying,
but as an audience member, right? You could say, hey, everyone, cool it.
Hey, everyone.
Why don't we cool it and see if you can get the crowd to relax?
Yeah, I'm going to make, I know I've been making a lot of wild suggestions here, and I'm not the tech guy. I just want to make a wild suggestion. I think that your Woodstock 99 VR experience could be a wonderful tool in therapy. It does feel like if everyone's bringing their own experiences, they'll be able to touch upon their own trauma through watching Jamiroquai
and through watching live. No, we have actually given this to therapists and a lot of people. I don't know if you're familiar with the therapy called EMDR.
I just talk to family members.
Okay, always the best therapy.
I've never believed in therapy. I call my son and I say, your old dad. He never calls me daddy because if he did, I'd break his neck. He says to me, Dad. And I say, what? He says, you can't call me for this. You got to call chatbot therapy.
I was going to suggest that. Chatbot therapy is one of the best therapies out there. The chatbot only, AI that's going to help you. But I'm going to say also,
this is so much more, though.
Maybe send a VR to Farmer Dan's son because I think he's probably hurting here.
Hey, I do have a question. I have a question here, and we'd have to get to traffic here in 1 second. There's no way this could go bad. There's no way this could malfunction.
Doesn't sound like it.
No, it. I'm saying anything goes.
Anything
goes. So, the user base, everybody has total access on the internet.
So okay? anything. Oh,
so there's
I
no.
Mean,
we
I,
do
I wish.
No content. We do no content management.
I wish I had total access to register
an email to use the Woodstock 99 virtual experience.
Wow. That's user friendly.
Do not need to connect it to your Facebook. It essentially is, I don't know if you guys are familiar with something called 4chan or Reddit.
No.
Okay.
No.
But it,
oh, I have heard of Reddit. I know Reddit.
Reddit.
I know
we're
Reddit.
Friends Chelsea. With the person who
Chainsley
invented
Reddit. Chainsley Reddit.
Right. Well, you can just simply put on the goggles and run wild. And again, we can't make it better. You can make it worse.
I mean, I got to say, the one thing that was always missing from Woodstock 99, the phrase, anything goes. You know, that is always what was needed for Woodstock 99. Just do what thou wilt shall be the law. Like a real Aleister Crowley vibe to Woodstock 99.
If you want to bring in one of those inflatable wiggly wobbly guys that have at a
used car dealer.
Dealership,
yes.
Okay. And if you want to put one of those in while Rusted Root are playing after
send me on my way.
Yeah. If you want
to find more milk because they're pissed off at me,
you can purchase one of those in game. And then all of a sudden at Woodstock 99, there's one of those wobbly waving guys.
Okay. That's great. We're going to do this.
That's definitely the only thing that's going to happen if you let anything go.
We're going to take an anything goes approach with this for Farmer Dan right after this break. But first, we do have to go to traffic. Art Spart.
108.9 The Hawk traffic with Art Spart.
Wow, it seems that we are indeed wasting away again in Margaritaville, folks. Well, first we talked about the burger situation. Well, now it seems that six margarita trucks, those are trucks carrying kegs upon kegs of Sammy Hagar's new collaboration with Jimmy Buffett, Mas Margarita. Well, it's all over the goddamn road. You can smell the citrus from here, folks, if you can't smell the milk coming off of Farmer Dan, if you know what I mean. If you drive anywhere near the H-22, you're going to get a whiff, and you could be immediately pulled over by Val Verde police and beaten because, quote-unquote, full-hand quotes, they think you're intoxicated. That's how the DUI cookie crumbles here in Val Verde. They beat you first and then ask questions. Oh, our rabid boys in blue. I say rabid because the outbreak of human rabies happening at the Val Verde police force. Absolutely disgusting. Just a bunch of cops foaming at the mouth, practically blind and angry. So angry. Looking good on Hawk Street, though. No issues near Mudhoney Junction. Hey, just stay away from 822. You're good to go, unless you're a Val Verde police officer, and even 400 rabies shots in the belly probably won't bring you back to normalcy. Hell, we dealt with mutant hawks. We can deal with this. I'm Art Spart, 108.9 The Hawk traffic.
It's time for weather on 108.9 The Hawk.
It's cold.
As you hear from Farmer Dan, it is still freezing.
So cold. The cows are so cold.
I mean, I hope that does something with those raccoons. I'm going to blame that rabies on the raccoon migration.
Fall festival days are happening right now.
All right, Farmer Dan was here to promote something, but...
And if you do the corn maze... And you happen to come across college students aged 19 to 21. They have been missing since 2 weeks ago Saturday.
Oh, I remember those. And the members of Kappa Kappa Flappa.
Kappa Flappa. And they're lost in the corn maze. So if you come across them as you're doing the corn maze, you know, help lead them out if you know the way out. If you don't know the way out, don't go in the corn maze. That's on the T-shirt.
I'm getting the sense that Val Verde is a stressful town, and it just seems like there's a lot going on here, and people might need an escape. It might need an escape
No. I mean, I don't have any anxiety at all or anything.
What are you talking about?
What I'm saying is, with the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience, you can put on the goggles, okay? And then you can actually be Chris Connolly standing from the MTV,
He's just smiling. This is great. Everlast.
Brian Setzer Orchestra,
And how could you not be smiling when you're seeing Brian Setzer there, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe here's the thing. Hey, you know, maybe I'll give a shout out to our Mayor David Lee Roth.
Mayor David Lee Roth, welcome.
Welcome, and maybe we should invest some of the town funds into getting individual Woodstock 99 VR experiences for everyone in this town. I still don't think any of us have anxiety. And I don't think so either. People say that, no, I don't have it, then they definitely do not have it. And that's
we're
going to
learn more
said.
About all of this coming up on 108.9. The Hawk.
When a group of former mental patients who are working part-time in a big box garden center are fired after the holiday rush, they'll need a cleanup in aisle 3 from all the murder. John Saxon, Karen Black, and the Beastie Boys in Sean S. Cunningham's Garden Center. Keep telling yourself, it's only a garden center. It's only a garden center. It's only a garden center. On Channel 8's Shocktoberfest. Channel 8, your home for great shit.
Hey, mama. Said the way you move, gonna make Grease Bastard sweat. Gonna make Grease Bastard groove. I wish. I'm Grease Bastard, host of Belly Full of Lead, every goddamn night on 108.9 The Hawk. Oh, you want to hear some Zeppelin? I can do that. More specifically, you want to hear Hot Dog from In Through the Outdoor? Done. Oh, but wait, you want Hot Dog to fade into Achilles' Last Stand from the album Presence, but with a few facts about what Robert Plant's health was like during the recording of that track? Well, now you're talking Grease Bastard's language, and I think we should get married. Just kidding. Or am I? What if I already have a wedding booked at the Edgewater Inn in Seattle, Washington, in the same room where Zeppelin did some very inappropriate stuff with some baby sharks? Look, I'm not saying I do, but I'm also not saying I don't. You're just gonna have to find out by listening to A Belly Full of Lead every night on 108.9 The Hawk. Oh, I'm gonna give you my love. Yeah, Grease Bastard style.
108.9 The Hawk, the Valley's greatest classic rock station. And there you go, sweet emotion. We go right to the phones. Caller number 108, you just won a pair of tickets to see Aerosmith live during their residency at the Valmart Amphitheater. You can pick from any of one of the 40 shows. Who do we got?
How we doing? How we feeling? How are we living today? This is Greg Lemon Sour from Going Deep.
Yes, Greg, you cannot win.
Oh, can't I? I talked to station manager Ron, and he said that there are some bylaws that let Lemon Sour get those tickets. The bylaw is Lemon Sour wants, Lemon Sour gets, so I'm going to be there. I'm going to be picking every single night. I'm not picking one. I'm picking all 40,
you
and I'm
going to
make sure that I yell
cuts,
out there,
right?
Hey, Toxic Twins, unless you're playing something from Rocks, I ain't listening.
Okay, well, if you talk to Boss Ron, the tickets are yours.
Oh, I talked to Boss Ron. He's right here. Great. We're hanging out. We're going through some dusty grooves. He's sitting next to me in my rocking chair that does not rock in front of my Marantz integrated amplifier.
Okay.
And we're going deep. We are deep with some dusty grooves.
Okay, that's great. Well, there you go. Ladies and gentlemen, the Aerosmith tickets just went to Greg Lemon Sour.
Everything's coming up Lemon Sour.
Your host for Going Deep. Your host for a lot of things here on 108.9 The Hawk, because he seems to be the current favorite of Boss Ron here
not
at 108.9 The
Hawk. Not
you really, like, you were cringing the whole time he was on the line there.
You know, I don't buy his anger. That's all I'm going to say. I feel like he saw personality and took it.
Okay.
That's
whose personality did he see?
Me.
Well, I don't know. I think you're giving yourself a lot of credit there.
Excuse
I love you to death, man.
Maybe
I love you to death.
He would like to mellow out by putting on the Woodstock 99 virtual reality goggles, okay? And then enjoying the rave tent as the Chemical Brothers play.
Well, speaking of the VR experience, we are going to let Farmer Dan put it on. Go ahead, Scotty, kill the bed. We're going to let Farmer Dan put it on, and he's going to walk us through what he's seeing.
Where do you want to send him?
Well, I think his mind is going to just send him wherever, right? His.
Let's put it in free roam mode.
Oh, yeah, take us on
and
a journey there.
Again, and Farmer Dan, we'll go to, do you guys want to go to when the fire started?
I think let's see where this takes him.
Okay.
Hopefully he'll be Farmer Dan.
Yeah, so he, obviously he is himself, and okay, so you put these
here
on.
We'll find out. God, I hope we end up at Godsmack, but I don't want to make this.
Here we go.
Crossing my fingers for Our
Remember
Lady Peace.
That you, even though it feels real, you are in a room.
Oh no, here we go again.
I might be able to help explain some of what he is. No, just tell us what you're seeing.
Guide him through this. People.
I see a crowd of people. They're all chanting my name.
My God, Jewel. Father Dan looks like he's on an ayahuasca trip. This is interesting.
Jewel!
Oh my goodness, is he the...
Jewel!
Is he the...
And he,
is
he really the, thinks that Jewel is there. That's how
I think he
is.
Thinks he is Jewel.
I look down and I see Jewel's hands. They're my hands.
Oh my gosh.
Wonderful.
They're my hands. These hands.
These hands, they are your own.
These hands are my own. And I look at the crowd. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
What do you see?
Now these hands are holding a gun.
Oh, yeah. My goodness.
Again,
now these hands.
In-game option.
Firing into the crowd.
Oh, my gosh.
Boom.
So this is something that anybody can do. After Jewel finishes up foolish games before she goes into down
she
so long, she could
everyone.
Start shooting Brian into Setzer. The crowd.
I mean, Brian the interesting Setzer's part here is you said,
down.
You said this Brian. Is what anyone could do,
Let
but I've got a feeling this is the deep psychoses of Farmer Dan.
Let
this is maybe something
Brian
only
Setzer.
Farmer Dan could do.
Again, like I said, we can't make it better. We can make it worse. That's Woodstock 99, the virtual reality experience.
No.
Lukather.
Dan, I would suggest go towards the umbilical brothers.
Now
not
I
the chemical
broken.
Brothers. Go towards the Australian comic duo who performed right in between Mo and Oleander. Then
now
you'll maybe calm down.
Brian Setzer's neck.
Oh my God. That doesn't even
Farmer Dan.
I'm looking at Elvis Costello.
This sounds like a younger Farmer Dan because, of course,
no
he ages 2 years
milk.
Every hour.
No milk for you, Elvis Costello.
Now, Farmer
Boom.
Dan, let me push a button. I'm putting, instead Boom. Of a gun, you can take a piece of the Woodstock art mural. Just basically a piece of plywood.
Definitely a good move. That won't cause any problems.
Yeah. And then do what you will to Elvis Costello with that piece of art.
Oh. Now I shove it through his throat.
Oh my goodness, we just lost Elvis Costello.
Well, again, in the game. Obviously, Elvis Costello is alive and well.
But just in case, Elvis Costello, can you please reach out to us and let us know that you are all right? Because I still, this is so real that I'm not believing it.
And now I'm holding two people from Our Lady Peace. I've got their heads, and I'm cramming them together.
Oh, my goodness.
And I feel the hunger.
Please don't tell me it's Duncan Couch and Steve Mazur from Our Lady Peace.
Steve Mazur and Duncan go.
Oh, goodness.
Well,
me.
It definitely is. It definitely is because they did come and do some ADR for us. And
oh, they did. That's
really
good. So they're alive,
the
then. That's good.
Yeah,
that's good. Okay.
Again, all of it is virtual. What's happening to Farmer Dan right now, his Woodstock 99 experience, it's going to be different than your Woodstock 99 experience unless you pair your devices.
Oh, wait a second. Hold on. Now, hey, Farmer Dan, I'm sorry. Sage, I have to interrupt. I know that you're saying it is all virtual, but I just got a breaking alert on my phone here. Duncan Coates and Steve Mazur from Our Lady Peace have just died.
Well, that
and
is
this
shocking
is in real life.
News.
And, oh, my mine is ringing up. Elvis Costello is in critical condition. In that, real life here.
These hands.
Oh, you've got
the terms. The terms and conditions are quite clear at the top
seven
of our
dust.
Game that we are not liable for anything.
And I don't think reality is paying attention to those terms and conditions anymore.
Do you
remember
when I was playing my Jewel song, Seven Dust? Do you remember when I played my Jewel song and you laughed?
Oh, no, don't threaten seven dust. Oh.
No one's laughing now.
Don't
I'm
take away
tank.
Our seven dust.
I am in a tank, and boom, there goes the East Stage.
I will say, Farmer Dan, for a 96-year-old man, has found his way around the virtual
there
reality.
Goes
he really
the
does.
Emerging
he gets it, I gotta
artist
say.
Stage.
And that, I think, is a testament to how user-friendly the technology is.
It is Mega a death. Testament. I think the death of Elvis Costello is not as much of a testament to this technology. Might be a couple bugs you gotta work out here.
Megadeth.
Oh, no. Dave Mustaine, don't take away Mustaine.
You can't run from me, Megadeth. I have the speed of light, and I'm running circles around you, and I take you back. back in time.
You know what? I'm gonna on my phone.
And now
right
we're
here.
Back in Metallica. And I I'm fire gonna, you. You are no I'm longer gonna, in Metallica.
Okay. Farmer Dan needs some help, and I'm sending two Skinny J's to back him up.
Oh yeah, two Skinny J's, you're our only hope.
Who? How did these two Skinny J's just get in front of me?
And then, you know,
too bad.
Oh no. You better get in there. You better start doing some reprogramming here. This experience
okay, why
is terrible. And I got the other two Skinny J's.
Take the thing off his head. Take the thing off.
Okay. Dan, are you okay? Are you alright? Farmer Dan, are you okay?
I think we've had some breakthroughs with Farmer Dan and unfortunately a couple deaths.
It all feels so real.
Yeah, it's not. You're in the studio. Yeah, it feels like you're Jewel.
You were
all
Jewel.
You're just a 96-year-old.
And breaking news, some shooting cases have been reopened against Jewel. All right, well, this is not good
I don't understand why the virtual reality is becoming actual reality and probably... fake news and
news.
Beyond the Woodstock 99 virtual reality experience, now would be a good time for me to talk about Lukather News Network, which is an open source platform for people that have been deplatformed, like
Alex Jones, you are able to
upload to our site. We're not going to censor you, and anything goes.
Not going to lie, I feel like this has been a long con to get us into your deplatformed social media here.
Sage, can I ask you guys? Yes.
Are you Sage Lukather?
I am.
What the hell just happened to Farmer Dan?
Farmer Dan is transformed right before
us. I am the machine.
Oh my goodness.
You can refer to me as the Lawnmower Man.
Oh, all right. Farmer Dan, the Lawnmower Man.
I think the technology.
You have been
sentient.
Playing with something you do not understand.
I understand, sir.
And you have created a world that is now part of our world. A world where Woodstock 99 never ends.
Oh my goodness, this sounds like we're in a hellscape.
To the edge of Valverde and see what I speak of.
Oh
this
my
was
God.
Holy shit, is that the Air Force
intention.
Base?
Yeah, it we
holy
appear,
oh my gosh,
shit.
And it's on this fire. Is, yep, okay.
It is almost like we are in some sort of David Lynch Twin Peaks situation.
It does feel that way, doesn't it?
It does feel that way.
Also feels like Farmer Dan looks a lot like Geoff Fahey. I never noticed that before, but...
He does look like Geoff Fahey.
Yeah, that's
Fall
interesting.
Fall festival days are happening.
That's fantastic.
At Shetland Creameries.
You know what? I think... gave him a better radio voice, so I kind of feel like...
I'm not against this Farmer Dan talking on the radio. He's speaking with a normal pitch. And look, sometimes when virtual reality becomes reality and that Woodstock 99 becomes a reality that never ended, and the
again,
horror
that's
never ended...
liable for any of
I mean, that just means maybe we'll get more documentaries about Woodstock 99.
Farmer Dan's back. I'm ready to start
the interview.
Oh, no, no. Farmer Dan,
we'll talk about Farm festival days at Shetland Creameries.
Yeah, no, Farmer, I don't
know
if all
everything
festival
you need
days are happening.
At Shetland Creameries. For over 40 years, you've expected Shetland Creameries to handle your dairy needs.
This does happen. A lot of people get lost in the experience,
when
and we
are
do
you boys
encourage
gonna
people.
Come to me?
Is he in a virtual reality loop here?
What happens is we don't suggest people play it for more than 3 hours at a time.
Oh.
Don't forget.
And sometimes the reality
and time does move different for Farmer Dan. We have realized
that. Don't forget.
I gotta
he's
say,
out of, a little bit out of our demo.
This is what
too.
Happens when you play fast and loose with legal
forget.
Rights and Woodstock 99 legalities.
No, we have the Bruce rights.
Bruce Hornsby in the range.
But
oh boy.
It's an anything goes experience.
I mean, anything goes, and that means Woodstock 99 still exists. But that also
don't
means
forget.
We're gonna have a bunch more documentaries coming down
don't
the pipeline
forget.
That'll probably have Farmer Dan in there murdering most of
don't
our
forget.
Famous musicians.
Don't forget. Mickey Hart and Planet Drum?
Yes.
October 20th at Shetland Creameries.
I'll never forget Mickey Hart and
so
Planet
listen,
Drum.
So listen, they...
Don't
they,
forget.
You're seeing the reality has not actually been affected. It's he's promoting upcoming shows.
Los Lobos!
Yes, and...
Los Lobos!
Nope,
with
I got a...
With Guster.
Got an alert on my phone. There are four more Woodstock 99 documentaries coming because it still exists. So I guess
I am. To be fair, I am a producer on two of those.
October 21st.
Because you got deep. It's the deep platforms. Woodstock 99. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this one's going to be the real truth. All right. I think Farmer Dan's caught here in a don't forget loop.
October 22nd.
Yep.
Can I talk to you guys about crypto? Are you crypto guys at all?
I don't think
we need to do that. Hey, thanks for coming on, Sage. And Farmer Dan,
I'm ready to do the interview.
And we're back.
Sage, please come back. I think it needs a little work from what I'm seeing on the outskirts of town. It's a never ending digital Woodstock 99 that is now part
4.0,
of
I think is our, what we're looking for here.
It's part of our landscape here.
Save us from our new hellscape.
Happy to come and introduce the technology. God. And I don't know if those raccoons, we can get those raccoons away from the Chevy Bolt.
That one's shit out of luck. You're screwed on that one.
Can we get the delay on that one? I'll use a ride sharing service.
I'll use an unnamed ride sharing service because I do stock in both.
Thanks a lot, Sage, for being on here. If you were planning on going to the Valverde Botanical Gardens, they are now Woodstock 99 all the time.
But G Love and Special Sauce seems to be playing there, so
they are hitting the stage right now. So if you wanted to see that in 99 and want to see it again in 2022, you can. Hey, don't forget, Mickey Mac is going to be out at the Motor Mile today. Mickey, we didn't get a chance to talk to you. I am sorry, but remember, if you can outrun a car, watch out for those cars. Hey, I got to say, it's been amazing being back here with you, Geoff, on the 108.9 The Hot Morning Show.
Great to be with you. It's
maybe
fantastic.
Next time it's me, you, and Wisp and Greg. That would be great, right?
A real reunion of sorts.
And you can have Everclear.
Hey,
Sage,
yeah, we said goodbye.
Yeah, Sage.
Okay.
All right.
Sage, we said goodbye. We are saying goodbye.
Well, life's been good.
Sage.
Life's been good. I'm just saying.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go. Now, I don't have to say what the song is. I was looking forward to this whole time. I wasn't on the air.
Welcome to the new hellscape.
Woo! Welcome to the new hellscape.
My dad is Steve Lukather. You don't talk to me that way. I talk to you this way.
My daddy, Steve Lukather.
Life's been good to me.
My daddy, Steve Lukather.
This has a long intro, and I will talk up to the post of it.
It is a real hard one to bump into.
That is a hard one. Sorry, hard one. And now we are in the interview. Welcome, Jake Fogelnest, to 108.9 The Hawk.
Oh, hey. What's up, guys?
What's up, man?
What's up?
How you doing?
This has been great.
Fantastic.
Wow. See, the thing about it is you come to 108.9 The Hawk with an idea. We all get on the mics at the beginning with an idea of what's going to happen.
Because also, sometimes we plan a little bit, but like just a little bit before. And it was like maybe 10 minutes before we started or something like that. I texted Jason. It was like, wait, what exactly are we doing today?
I mean, a lot of these shows are like that, though. It's mainly like, who are we going to be?
Yes.
Like, am I going to be Wisp? Is he going to be Greg? And then we kind of let it see what happens. From there, now there is a full-on virtual ghost version of Woodstock 99 that never ends, where the Valverde Botanical Garden used to be,
and that's our new reality.
We have to deal with that all the time because it's canon.
Your local backyard. Exactly.
It is canon now. You don't even have to go to Rome, New York.
Exactly.
You don't have to go.
But this is also why we, for a long time, we're like, we got to get Fogelnest on here.
We got to get Fogelnest on.
Thank you, guys. I've been a fan of the show.
Oh, thank you, man.
Someone out there, check on John Entwistle.
Yes. He's roaming around there. Watch out.
Yeah. Jewel really did a number on Entwistle. Yeah. You know, once she got out of her tank at Woodstock 99. After chasing down Seven Dust.
Yes.
You can't make it better, but you can make it worse.
Yes.
You can make it worse. Of course, Jake Fogelnest, a very good friend of the show. And man, you've done so much. You've lived so many lives, Jake.
Yeah, I'm retired at this point. I'm done.
Yeah.
I'm done.
I mean,
the beauty is, like, I was trying to remember for, I mean, for me, I was like, did I meet Jake before we had you on, like, my old podcast, Worst Gig Ever? And I had
you
a brief, one of the Break Up Your UCB. Band shows at UCB?
Probably at, like, a UCB thing.
And
I
then
feel like
I, maybe, you were on.
Maybe Moby was there.
Yeah, exactly. It's like Pinfield's, Matt Pinfield being like, yeah, of course, music. And
hey, it's so great to see you, Geoff. Hey,
exactly.
It's great to see all Amen.
I love Pinfield.
I do. I want to
get Pinfield on here. I really do.
Oh, he'll do it.
But I'm pretty sure we did a worse gig with you where half the time, I swear, we just talked about the Cro-Max and how scary New York is.
I think that was because it was at that time
when they stabbed the someone.
Harley yes. might have. He was like very upset and a little stabbing happened.
Yeah. But then we had a worst gig ever video version where we would do half hour shows on the official comedy.
Official comedy on,
you know, the
YouTube.
Network we all certainly remember existed for 1 year. But I forgot
like
until this.
They was like, oh, we're going to give YouTube channels some money. And people opened up offices and
then literally the week after the money ran out, we got an email like, nope, it's over. But I remember, I forgot until this morning that we did a bit on there that I rewatched this morning for the first time in years that I was like, man, all of us have been doing this type of comedy for so long where we did a whole
it's
bit
true.
Where
yeah.
it was you doing the worst MTV VJ bumpers and we just put you in a terrible
I remember that.
A
yes,
terrible
he gave me
Hawaiian
some
shirt.
He gave me a shirt.
Oh my
and I just
God.
And one of the funniest ones to me was like you did one for Robert Downey Jr.'s record and then you were just like, and he might show up in your bedroom unexpectedly because I think he had just crept into someone's bedroom recently.
Is it that long ago?
Yeah.
Oh my
Wait,
God.
And this
also,
is,
the
this
funniest
is
joke
Tony
to me.
Stark?
Yeah.
No,
I can't remember.
That might have been a tasteless joke at the expense of Robert Downey Jr.'s newfound sobriety, for which I apologize. God.
But the funniest joke was Phil Collins had a big band record, and you said something like, so you better watch your back, Count Basie. And I was like, this is why we've got Jake on. This is why we got Jake on. Yeah. It's like years and years of my motto alienating through specificity, as I keep saying.
Let me speak on, like, what did Phil Collins do that was so offensive? Really, at the end of the day.
Nothing. He is my favorite. They were my favorite band.
He did his solo stuff. He did adult contemporary that people liked. He was, I did a whole thing on an examination. Either of you, you ever see the movie Buster?
Oh, yes. I remember seeing you did Buster, and I was like, thank
you. You're the two guys. I went crazy. Yeah. I called my mom. I'm like, Mom, remember Phil Collins was in a movie called Buster? She said, absolutely. Have you seen it? She said, nope. I could not find anyone that had seen the movie Buster.
Of course.
I ordered a DVD, sat down with my wife and my mother-in-law. We watched Buster. Do you know what? We were like, pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hit you even harder here. I saw Buster in the theater.
Holy shit.
Because my mom Phil Collins. Mom was the biggest Phil Collins fan. I remember, I don't know if I've ever told this story on the Hawk
before.
She was
in too deep.
But I remember, Karen Gore was in too deep with Phil Collins. But I remember
that's coming to Forever Dog, in too deep with Karen.
In too deep. Yes. Probably. But I remember driving
down
the road.
That will be the name of me and Jason's Genesis podcast that we've been threatening in for like
deep.
A year. In too deep.
I thought it was going to be Take Me Home.
Oh, right. Or it'll change every episode.
Home.
But sorry, go on.
Or it's just called Because I Don't Remember. but I remember driving down the road and we were listening to Rick Astley and Dad looked at me and he was
Together Forever. I don't Rick roll people. Together Forever them.
Yeah,
that's what
exactly.
I
love Rick Astley. He's not a joke to me. I think he's a fucking great lawyer.
Brannigan people. I like to.
Yeah.
Brannigan. I like to She's in Control people.
I like worry, to was not was people.
Yeah. A great record, by the way.
Door,
Laura Brannigan's record.
Floor.
Somebody says
it's a great record. It's got Hello Dad. I'm in jail. Hey everybody, it's three white guys talking about stuff.
Liquid Television's own I'm in jail, Dad.
Hello Dad. I like it here. It's nice.
But Dad turns to me and he says, Rick Astley has the best goddamn voice I've ever heard.
Yeah.
The next week I'm driving. almost the same spot in Virginia, and Take Me Home's on the air, and my mom turns to me and says, almost verbatim, Phil Collins has the best goddamn voice of anyone.
And your mother was right.
Loved. She still does. She still does.
I like Phil Collins. I know he's had, you know, several wives and he's ill now and stuff.
His book is heart-wrenching.
That's the thing.
His book's tremendous.
I read the book and I was just like, geez, what did Phil Collins ever do to deserve this? And I think it was, you know, I Can't Dance. When Genesis did that. Yeah,
but I love
everybody,
that.
It's one of the few I can't stand behind in my favorite band. I had this revelation because I freaked out the other day. I'm completely not aware that we're on a podcast right now. This is just a true thing that happened to me.
Okay.
I realized I didn't have a copy of Regatta to Blank. I looked. I was like, oh, I'm going to go listen to Regatta to Blank.
No.
I had four Police records. And then I got double 10-inch Regatta to Blank. It's already been corrected.
Okay.
And then I was thinking about, because I'm listening to my Miles Copeland's audiobook right now. And I'm like, Sting, 1985. We allowed it. Like, people loved, like, you know, that stuff. And it don't work for me.
No.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll say this, because I know our friend Tom Sharpling, he hates Billy Joel. But would you take 1985 Billy Joel? Or would you rather have 1985 Sting?
Billy Joel.
Like, think about that.
Oh.
Billy Joel.
What? I'll take the Billy Joel.
I mean, that's because, you know, Sting, that fucking Andy Summers helping him out to be awesome in Police. And that, you know, like,
yeah.
Because then you go to those Andy Summers solo records, like, oh, man, there's some real fucking interesting stuff on these records.
Yeah.
Like,
Miles Copeland in his autobiography is just like, I told Andy Summers that his record, you know, wasn't very good. And then I went in and I played it for MCA. And they were like, this is crap. We don't know how to promote this. So I set up a meeting for MCA. And then I said, tell them what you think. And they said, well, we love it. And I don't know why. That's my Miles Copeland impression.
I was looking at Miles Copeland in the room.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, my God.
I ran FBI, IRS, CIA, and now I run DOJ.
So tell us about your podcast you're doing right now. You have your Patreon.
Yeah, but it's also free now because I realized it did like over 111 of these things.
And right.
So you can get it. Jake Fogelnest free episodes.
Hell yeah. And you can get that wherever you get podcasts.
Yeah. And then if you want it as a TV show and you want the bonus stuff and stuff, you go to www.jake.army and that's a Patreon. And you can give me a few bucks. I'll take it.
Yeah.
I only have a kid on the way.
Well, Jesus Christ, wrap it up. He'll take it, people. Jesus.
Or you could, you know, rob me. And what it is I'm giving people what I think is the most important news and cultural affairs out there each week. And
okay.
Last week on the show, to me, that was talking about, you know, that song, you know, 1, 2, 3. Look comes Mr. Lee. Did you know they did that?
Oh, yes. Yeah. It was called Mr. Lee, wasn't it?
Yeah, Mr. Lee.
And I know that song because I had a teacher named Mr. Lee.
They did a
sequel. Oh, my God. Really?
Yeah. You can Google it right now. I Shot Mr. Lee.
No.
It's a splatter platter. It's a death disc.
Here comes Mr. Lee. And then, got a gun to his head. Hey.
Yeah. It basically is that. And it's the same song. It's just, you know, I Shot Mr. Lee. Should have never did it. It's real. It was out there. Did you know? You didn't. Your life is better.
Ever.
Do you need to see TV commercials from the movie Foxes? Because I found them all. All right. Like, this is the most important stuff that, and people won't talk about it. Rachel Maddow's not doing it.
Oh,
Bill Maher's not doing it.
Keith Olbermann is talking about this.
Oh, he is?
My motto of alienating through specificity was maybe started by Jake Fogelnest.
I honestly think that should be a Hawk t-shirt. That should
not
be a Hawk
make
t-shirt.
You any money.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Welcome to all of our careers. Uh-oh.
But I honestly could sit here and talk to you guys.
Specificity will definitely be a t-shirt.
I could talk to you guys about sequel songs forever because, of course, one of my favorite sequel songs, The Monster Swim.
I gotta be honest, not familiar
I'm
with
gonna
that.
Guess main oh, you're not focus familiar on with this. Creature from the Black Lagoon doing so some it shit
is, it is
Bobby Boris Pickett
it is Bobby the, Boris the double Pickett's dip. Double uh-huh. dip so I figure with all these sequel songs like everybody thinks it's gonna be Let's Twist Again
right
because that was there, huge
the jump
that one gets like, two the, squeaks because it's the weirdest
discovery, the discovery of the Bobettes who did Mr. Lee
yeah.
that they the leap it was their second song. I shot Mr. Lee. Like, it's real. You can hear it on the
There's
my
a lot of missing stuff in between there. Like, we need like, some understanding happened? Of what Yeah, First what went down.
That what was, happened?
That
Why?
Was the heat down? Two of the time. You know, you needed to know.
Funny to me.
What
and
happened
then it's
to
like,
Hannah?
How did I
And Michael
go-
Mann wrote both.
And they how got a I- great ass.
How but, did I go 43 years on the planet and like not, you know, and that's what I'm trying to find.
Yeah, we're all the same age. We're all the same age. So this all hits us. But I highly recommend it. When you get off this, please watch Monster Swim. Watch the video of him doing it on Bandstand, because Dick Clark like sets it up like he had such a hit last year with the Monster Mash this year. And it's boring.
It's going to be even bigger.
And it's Bobby Boris Pickett doing like the same like faces.
Yeah.
With like a monster, like a big squid behind him and talking about like surfing. Like all the monsters came out to surf. It's one of the greatest things ever. It's my favorite Halloween song. I don't fuck the mash. Pickett. Give me the swim. That's
put
a t-shirt
shirt. Too. Fuck the mash.
Fuck
give me
the
mash.
Give me the swim. And it's just
We're
a picture
wear that.
Of.
Can't wear that out at Albertsons.
I mean, yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Cradle of Filth fan will wear that.
Thank you so much for being part of this, Jake. We got to have you back. Anything else to plug? It. Anything else going on? Or just Jake Army?
No. Don't bother me. That's my plug. Let me do my thing.
That's the
ultimate do my thing.
Yeah.
And I'm having fun. And if you want to be involved, great.
Me.
But otherwise, just leave me alone.
I get it.
You got to be. Listen, I'm not trying to say I don't want to do stuff, but you know, I'm just saying
I don't want
what
to do
kind
stuff.
Of what kind of stuff is it
exactly,
you know what I mean?
That
at
is
this,
that's
at
my
this
motto.
Point at this point no I just want to if people want to send good wishes, because we got this kid on the way. I'd like it to be born healthy and happy and strong, and that's in January. That's what I'm focused on right
when
now.
When this child is of age, is there going to be a day when you're like, well, it's time for you to start Squirt TV?
No.
You're never going to pass that on.
Unless
they want to.
If it's, you know, with the parents that this child has, my wife and I were both a little nuts. And I was the weird six-year-old who's like, yeah, I want to do this. I'm writing a letter to John Waters. And then he calls me. Yeah, that's like... you know, if the kid is, I'm not going to not be supportive.
Yeah.
No. You know, I'm not going to be like, no, you can't, but I will say.
Because your folks were supportive to it.
They were,
not going to stop them, but not going to push them into it.
Yeah. I'm
right.
Not,
that's the motto. That's I have
the
as well.
Onion article. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Right.
Please,
right.
Don't send me like a Ramones onesie or something. I'm just not going to. Like, you know, leave me alone, and also, you know, say hi. You
my
know?
Son
say
had hello. To name my son had to name three Kate Bush songs before he could wear the Kate Bush shirt that he currently wears. You know,
now she
and he did. Babushko is his number one song, and I was like, "You're a deep cut kid. What is up
that
with
is,
you?"
I heard
that is a deep cut kid.
She is doing well.
I mean,
she's in Metallica
imagine?
Now.
I can't.
She is in Metallica now.
No, but like, just like our friend Curtis Quinn decides to needle drop running up that hill or whatever, and then all of a sudden it's like, I made 2.2 million pounds.
Oh, yeah. Oh, she's making so much money off this, and it's the greatest thing.
Yeah, it truly is.
And
Peter Gabriel's going nuts, just like, please use Sledgehammer.
Yes, or at least don't give up. If you
Games
want Kate.
Games without frontiers, you know? Come on.
Jesus, use the Christmas special song where we're doing a Roy Harper.
I'll leave
cover.
You with this. Has this ever happened to you? You go to buy a copy of one of the Peter Gabriel solo albums. You come home.
It's the German
put it on
one.
Your turntable, and it's a German one.
This is a friend
that
of the show, John Murray, stayed at my house, and he goes, "I gotta ask you. I was looking at your records. Why do you have multiple copies of?"
Yeah.
And I was like, "Oh, buddy, you don't know about the German records? So here
it
we
happened
go."
To me. I was like, "Oh yeah, this is the album with Games Without Frontiers on it," and I put the thing on, and then it's just like, who is that guy?
Interesting part about those Germans, they have more syllables in their words, and sometimes they don't exactly match up with the tune. But the thing is, there is slightly different music and track listing on those German ones. So that's kind of what
I was at first. I was confused, and I was like, what the hell? And then I was like, Yes, yeah. This is the best. And then
Hans Ventunschreiben. It sounds like Rammstein singing Peter Gabriel.
It's so great.
Fire coming out of Peter Gabriel's dick, and you don't know what's going on.
Because all the album covers are the same. Yeah, fire coming out of my dick. And he's gonna, much like Roger Waters,
come out of my dick.
Like, sure, Peter, we can have it.
Sure, Peter, whatever.
It's Peter Gabriel.
If you're here to listen to me play songs from So, that's fine.
Yeah.
But if you don't agree with my politics, then you can enjoy this fire coming out of my dick.
That's all fine and good, Peter, but do I have to have fire come out of the Chapman's dick?
Yes, Tony Levin.
Yes, Tony, you have to have it. This is from my new covers album. Yeah, this is Rammstein with Du Hast.
It's a very gentle version of Du Hast.
Peter Gabriel do Du Hast.
It would be
it'd be so nice.
Anything
to have a lot of piano.
He does, I'll take it. Jesus.
Yeah.
It would be gut-wrenching.
Jake,
no
this
offense
is
to Steve Lukather, by the way. I love you, Steve Lukather.
We love you,
truly,
Steve
Toto
Lukather.
Hydra is one of the greatest records that has ever existed.
Totally just...
Because Steve Lukather was waiting for that. He was like, I'm going to give them until the end of this fucking podcast.
Seriously,
and
people.
They don't fucking apologize.
Yeah. Find the Toto playing in Japan live video from the Hydra tour. It'll blow your mind. But also, they all are wearing kimonos.
We are the only podcast that will say, find the live show from the Toto Hydra Hydra tour in Japan.
Their version of 99 is killer.
Check out my new business, Leather by Lukather. Leather goods.
Hello, Duffer Brothers. This is Peter Gabriel reminding you that I have fire coming out of my dick.